F1 World action for you today. Welcome along, everybody, as we look down at our grid. Who's your driver to follow? With top speeds reaching 215 miles per hour, only a few places can challenge Monza's crown as the fastest track in Formula One. Hard braking zones going into the three chicanes make up the majority of the 11 corners on this 3.6 mile circuit. And just in case the slipstream wasn't enough, two DRS zones will help encourage some close action. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position, just ahead of George Russell, who starts this event from P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Sainz, Stroll, Verstappen, Perez, Hamilton, Fernando Alonso, Albon, Hülkenberg, Magnussen, Sargeant, Ocon, today's F1 World Challenger, Bottas, Tsunoda, Oscar Piastri, Norris, De Vries, and Zhou Guan Yu. And now it's time to head down to the track. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Okay, today's target, P6, P6.
Final lap. Let's go. Final lap.
there we go. There's the checkered flag and we hit our target position. Well done, mate. Well done.
There it is then, victory in the Italian Grand Prix, an historic race and an achievement they can be immensely proud of. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, when you overtake that many people, I'd certainly hope you'd win the race. Their car was really effective in the slipstream here today, and the team will be pleased that they didn't cook the engine, given how long they were spending in the hot air behind other cars. They had a lot of confidence to push their tyres hard as well, especially going into the corners, which allowed for some late braking and some exciting passes.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way onto the podium now. It's a new format for me, it might be a new format for you as well, but there's no doubting that the action comes thick and fast in F1 world. I can't wait for the next time.